Management of IUGR and the calcium, magnesium, zinc, antioxidants, vitamin C, E and high protein diet, all of these have been advocated, but they do not have any proven role in the management of IUGR. Only if the pregnant female is malnourished, she is given high protein diet. So the pregnant female should be advised balanced diet. Again, the role of bed rest in left lateral position is controversial. And corticosteroids should be given for fetal lung maturity. And as IUGR babies are at high risk, careful fetal monitoring should be done. The patient should be asked to keep daily fetal movement count, and NST, biophysical profile and Doppler studies should be done for fetal evaluation. And the definitive management, it depends on the umbilical artery Doppler. If the umbilical artery Doppler is normal, then in that case, we continue NST biweekly. Umbilical artery Dopplers are repeated, and if all the parameters remain normal, then the pregnancy is continued till 38 weeks of gestation and we deliver the patient thereafter. If the umbilical artery Dopplers are abnormal, then we look for the SD ratio, that is the systolic to diastolic ratio, and if this is increasing, then we continue the fetal monitoring and try to take the pregnancy up to 37 weeks of gestation and deliver thereafter. But in subsequent umbilical artery Dopplers, if we find absent end diastolic flow, then we try to take the pregnancy up to 34 weeks of gestation and deliver thereafter. And if there is reversal of diastolic flow, in this case, the fetal death is imminent, and so immediate termination of the pregnancy has to be done.